Hello students, today let us start a chapter in your second year PUC which comes under the unit 6, chapter 2, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. So first let us know what is reproduction. It is the process in which organisms give rise to its offspring of its own kind is called reproduction. In reproduction, there are two types of reproduction, that is asexual and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the reproduction where there is no formation of gametes. Sexual reproduction is the reproduction where there is formation and fusion of gametes. And that sexual reproduction we will be discussing in this chapter in flowering plants. So flowering plants, it is a group of plants that is the angiosperms which produces the flowers. And hence here we will be discussing the sexual reproduction in angiosperms. So the topics which we will be discussing in this chapter is flower, a fascinating organ of angiosperms, one of a very interesting organ in the angiosperms, and the pre-fertilization structure and events. Pre-fertilization means the events which is going to take place before the fertilization is called pre-fertilization structure and events. Fertilization, it is a fusion of male and female gametes which results in the formation of the zygote called as fertilization. And in angiosperms, the fertilization is a special type of fertilization called double fertilization because two male gametes will be fusing, and hence it is called as a double fertilization. All the events which is going to take place before fertilization and the structure which are involved, and that we will be studying in the pre-fertilization. And after the fertilization, in the flower, the ovary is going to develop into fruit. Inside the fruit, ovule is going to develop into the seeds. So the ultimate products of sexual reproduction is the formation of the fruit and seed, and all that structure and events we will be discussing in detail in post-fertilization structure and events. And the last topic called apomixis and polyembryony, and we'll discuss that in detail when we take up the topic. Now coming to the first topic of this chapter, that is the flower, a fascinating organ of angiosperms. As I've already told you, it's one of a very interesting organ in the angiosperms because it is mainly meant for the reproduction. So in the plants, it is meant for the reproduction, for the formation of fruit and seed, but in general, flowers are used for various purpose, and flowers, it is used for various, it is used as an objects for various values, that it is used as an ornamental purpose for its beauty. And also in some of the religion, without the flower, the worship of God will be incomplete, and hence it also has its religious value. Along with this, the flower has a very immense relationship with the human being from time immemorial. Means it is used, flowers are used to convey the human feelings, that is like love, happiness, and also to express the sorrow for anybody's death, that is like grief and mourning. In this way, flower has an intimate, in an immense relationship with human beings from long back ago. So coming, apart from all this, coming back to the topic, that is a fascinating organ of angiosperms, the first topic of this chapter. So before going in detail to the sexual reproduction, very basically we should know the parts of the flower, because without knowing the parts of the flower, you cannot proceed with the sexual reproduction. We have already studied the parts of the flower in your first year PUC, but let us recall it once again. There are basically four parts present in the flower. And the stalk of the flower, which is called as pedicel. Stalk of the flower is called pedicel, and the tip of the pedicel is slightly swollen, which is called thalamus. Called as thalamus. On this thalamus, the very important parts of the flower, that is four parts, are present in the form of circles, which is called as whorls of the flower. The very first whorl of the flower, that is the sepals, and these together, a group of sepals is called calyx. Group of sepals is called as calyx. This is the first whorl of the flower, that is the first part of the flower. Sepals are green in color, and mainly when the flower it is in bud condition, the sepals will cover the flower and it will protect the flower in bud condition. That is the main function of the sepals. All together sepals, it is called as an calyx. It is the first whorl. Coming to the second whorl of the flower, that is petals. All together, many petals, the number may vary from flower to flower, called corolla. And this is the second whorl of the flower. Petals, generally it will be brightly colored. It will attract the insects for the pollination. So mainly brightly colored, petals are brightly colored and it will attract the insects for the pollination. So pollination in general, that is a transfer of an male gametes from the anther to the, that is transfer pollen grains from the anther to the stigma, that is called as a pollination. Transfer of an pollen grains from the anther to the stigma is called pollination. Such type of pollination is brought about through various agents. In that, insect is one of a pollinating agent which will transfer the pollen grains from anther to stigma, and that petals are brightly colored and attract the insects for the pollination. The third important whorl in the flower, that is a male reproductive part, that is androecium. Here you can see the filament like structures here which is present, called filament. At the tip of the filament there is a lobe like structure called anther. Let me repeat, this filament, stalk like structure called filament, tip of the filament, lobe like structure called anther. Together filament plus anther called stamen. Such type of many stamens together called androecium. The male reproductive part of the flower produces the male gametes in the anther lobe. In the anther lobe, the male gametes are produced inside the pollen grains. We will be discussing that later in detail. That is, all together the stamens is called androecium, male reproductive part, filament, anther, together called stamen, group of stamens called androecium, male reproductive part. That is the third whorl of the flower, third very important part of the flower. Coming to the fourth part of the flower, that is, here you can see a swollen part which is called ovary, swollen part, and a long stalk like structure called style, and the tip called stigma. Generally it will be sticky in nature, stigma, to receive the pollen grains. Ovary, style, stigma, all together called as carpel or pistil. Carpel or pistil. The carpel may be one in number or many. This group of carpels, or if it is one, It is also called as gynoecium. Gynoecium, the female reproductive part of the flower. Let me repeat. Ovary, style, stigma, called as together called carpel. The other name of carpel is pistil. And this carpel, if it is one or if it is many, a group of carpels, it is called gynoecium. If it is also one carpel, then it is also called as gynoecium. The female reproductive part of the flower. And this will produce the female gametes. Generally, the female gametes, it will be produced inside the ovary. So in this way, the androecium produces the male gametes and the female reproductive part, gynoecium, produces and female gametes. And later, there will be a fusion of male and female gametes, which is called as fertilization. So in this way, the flower has mainly four important parts, that is the calyx, the individual unit sepals, second oval corolla, individual units petals, the third oral androecium, and individual unit stamen, later stamen in turn made up of filament and anther, the fourth oral of the flower, that is gynoecium, individual units called carpel or pistil. Carpel, it is made up of ovary, style and stigma. In this way, these are the four important parts of the flower. Whereas the calyx and corolla are not directly involved in the reproduction. The just sepals will protect the bud, petals will attract the insects. Because of that, these two are considered as an non-essential whorls. Non-essential orals, because they are not directly involved in the reproduction. Whereas the androecium and gynoecium, they are directly involved in the reproduction. They are considered as an essential orals, very important in the reproduction, and hence they are considered as an essential orals. So in this way, the flower made up of calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, four important parts of the flower, and they are placed on a swollen structure called calamus, and the stalk of the flower, which is called as a pedicel. So it is very, very important to know the structure of the flower, because it is the one where the further concepts, that is, we will be studying how the gametes are produced, how the gametes is going to fuse to form the undergo fertilization, forms the zygote, development of fruit, seed, all that we will be studying in the flower itself. So hence, it is very, very important to study the structure of the flower. In our future classes, that is in pre-fertilization structure and events, we will be talking about the stamen. We will take one stamen, and in that, the anther. In the anther, the pollen grains are produced. So what is the structure of the anther? How the pollen grains are produced? How the male gametes are produced? All that we will be discussing in this stamen. And then that is the carpel, ovary, style and stigma. The female gamete are produced inside the ovary. So we will take up a single carpel, how the gametes are produced and how the fusion will take place. All that we will study in our further classes, that is pre-fertilization structure and events. Thank you.